When you install PI BatchView, one of the things you get in the installation is an add-in to Microsoft Excel. And when you install it, it appears in a menu that's labeled PI. If you happen to have PI Datalink also installed, the batch search functionality will be incorporated within that same menu. So it sort of looks like they belong together. And they do actually belong together, but they don't have any dependency on one another. You can have PI BatchView installed without having PI Datalink installed. There's no reason to go over the BatchView for Excel search functionality. It's the same search functionality that's found in the BatchView Quick Search and the Add-in to Process Book. And so if you need some instruction on how to use that, please see the earlier sections on how to search for batches. There are some settings that are unique to the BatchView for Excel option. Some of them are very similar to the results panel in Process Book in the add-in, where you can see the available columns and you can add them to the selected columns. These are the columns that are going to appear in your spreadsheet when you perform a query. The BatchView for Excel, just like the other BatchView products that we have, uses custom name sets. And the one thing that is unique to the BatchView for Excel add-in is the hierarchy and the levels shown. And you can choose what level to show, and you can choose whether to differentiate or delineate those levels either using an indentation, using separate columns or formatting, or you can choose to delineate these columns by using Excel groupings, and they're not mutually exclusive. Here's an example of some column configurations. We've got batch ID, start time, end time, duration, product, procedure, and PI server, and those are shown in that order on the spreadsheet when the results are returned. Here's an example of a hierarchy where in section one, or in screenshot one, we simply show an example of data returned that was just single level, just getting the unit batch level. And then we have the second spreadsheet here, second shot, where we're showing things based on indentation. And the third thing we're showing is based on separate columns and Excel grouping. So you've got a lot of visual choices, a lot of visual options to display your data. Let's take a quick look at some of the visualization options that we have in PI BatchView for the Excel add-in. I've opened up an Excel spreadsheet, and I'm going to select add-ins and PI Batch Search. And I'm going to use my digesters that we had earlier, digester 1. And let's go back 4 hours. And if we perform that kind of query, we get the results that we expect to get in the preview window at the bottom of the search panel. And when I click OK, those results are simply exported out to the spreadsheet. So you can see I've got a very basic report with a count of five line items, five unit batches. Well, if I want to add some detail to that, I can right-click and then select Batch Search. That will bring up the dialog box as it appeared originally. I can go into Settings, and let's say I want to show down to two sub-batch levels. I click OK. And what you'll see is that instead of just the unit batch layer, I have all of my layers. However, this gets a little bit difficult because you see we've got one line item here for our unit batch, and then we scroll down and we can see our next unit batch starts here, but that doesn't really give us a good feeling for what's sort of under what in terms of hierarchy. So I'm going to right click on the data array and select Batch Search again, and I have the choice of either showing levels using indentation by either separate columns or formatting cells. Separate columns is a nice way to do it because what you get is a separate column for each level. So you can see here that I've got batch ID, PI subbatch, and PI subbatch. So every level of subbatch gets its own column. I can very easily see the delineation between the layers and hierarchical levels in this count. And finally, I want to show you just about adding Excel grouping. This is a feature of Excel. It's not necessarily our product. We're just using an Excel product. And this allows us to put the traditional expand and collapse layers into the margins. So this allows us to use the Excel grouping function in order to see the data that we want to see. Batch view becomes especially powerful when you connect or link its usage to PI Datalink. Here's an example where I've got all of my purple columns, that's all batch view query data, and my PI Datalink, that's all PI Datalink query data. And you can see that I'm using my start time and end time of each unit batch run as a basis to do a calculation. In this case, I'm looking at the average and maximum values for a specific variable. In this case, it looks like it's the temperature tag. So I'm combining a batch view query with a data link calculation and returning results that that have a symbiotic relationship with one another. Most often, you're going to want to use the calculated data function in Datalink, and the calculated data function retrieves things like minimums, maximum, averages, totalizations, things like that. And the calculated data function becomes very powerful when it's used with batch data. And most of the time with batch data, it's used to retrieve the start time and the end time. You will see something called a conversion factor, and a conversion factor is only used when you're dealing with totals. And it's because the PI server does not keep unit of measure. So we have to use a conversion factor when the unit that you're measuring is anything other than units per day. Because we don't keep unit of measure in the PI system, we assume units per day. So if you're doing a totalization, and remember, this is only for totalization, when you're doing a totalization and your device is measuring, say, gallons per minute or cubic meters per minute, you'll need to use a conversion factor of 1440 because your units are units per minute. Of course, if you are measuring in units per day, then your conversion factor remains 1. Also, you can use aliases to get data. We can use aliases to resolve the tag names through the PI Datalink alias function as well. So you can combine module relative displays and reports with batch view to come up with some very powerful visualizations. Let's use a quick example of combining a batch view query with a PI Datalink query. I'm going to go to my add-ins, PI batch search, and I'm going to use my traditional digester one. And I'm going to go back, let's go back 8 hours, back 4 hours. But I want to narrow this down. I want to only get a certain value. I want to find out what the maximum temperature of my temperature tag was, my temperature alias was, for the sulfate cooking phase. So to do that, I'm going to go to my advanced search, and I have my PI unit batch criteria correct, but I want to add to the sub-batch criteria the sulfate cooking attribute. And once I do that, then I have my criteria correct. But I want to change my settings. I don't want all of these columns. In fact, I don't need PI server, I don't need procedure, I don't need unit name or product. All I want is the ID, start time, and end time. And I will need to go to one sub-batch level, and I do want to show my levels of indentation. So what I end up with is is results that look like this, where I have my sulfate cooking phases shown. And I want to find out what the maximum value for the temperature tag was there. So the first thing I need to do is I need to figure out what the tag name is, because to get the max value, I'm going to need a tag name. So the alias I want to use is temperature. And so I'll put temperature up there. And what I'm going to do is resolve that in the field below it using the Datalink function alias. So I'll select the alias function. And what I want to pick is the alias, And the module path, I don't have it displayed on the spreadsheet, so I'm going to simply search for it. And if you remember, this was my digester 1, so I can just come down here until I find digester 1. Oops, click OK, and then OK. And I can see that I've resolved to my tag ppdigest1temp. And so if I want to find out what the maximum value was for that, I can do max temp. And for my sulfate cooking phase, I can use my PI Datalink calculated data function. My tag name is going to be my digest1temp tag. My start time is going to be my start time of the sulfate cooking phase, and my end time is going to be the end time of that phase. And the calc mode that I want is maximum, and I do want to show the max time for that. So you can see that if I just highlight these particular fields here, you can see that between the 12:46 and about 1 o'clock, about a minute after 1 o'clock, the maximum temperature reached was 163,915, and that was reached at 12:49. So not very long into the start of that phase, that maximum temperature was reached. So you can see that I've got one area of my spreadsheet using PI BatchView query, and another area of my spreadsheet using PI Datalink query. And so I've combined them to create a report of my batches over the last 4 hours and the max temperature. And I could simply repeat this down through the other sulfate cooking boxes.